Dear students, in the last class we have seen model agro advisories. In this class we would like to see the mass communication mode for agro advisories and their effectiveness. A state of art of agro advisory services, that is AAS, is being issued to the farmers on a real time basis in India by using medium range weather forecast at agro climate zonal level by 1991 and at district level from 2008 onwards. The central activity of AgroMet advisory services is handled by the Division of Agriculture Meteorology of IMD in association with state agricultural universities, Indian Council of Agriculture Research, and also its research institutes, Indian Institute of Technology, state and union department of agriculture, as well as the Prasar Bharati and other media like radio, TV, as the printing media like newspapers. The AAS bulletin, the agro advisory bulletin, was primarily issued for the farmers. It has four different types. The district level AgroMet advisories are issued for the farmers. The state level composite agro advisory service bulletins are issued for the state level planners, that is for the state crop weather watch group. And similarly, the AAS bulletin is primarily targeted for the national level planners, namely Department of Agriculture and Cooperation, Ministry of Agriculture, and also communicated to all the related ministries from state to central, as well as the organizations and NGOs for their use. Likewise, it also provided for the other users like fertilizer industry, pesticide industry, irrigation department, and seed corporation, transport, and other organizations, which they provide input to the agriculture. The broad activities of AgroMet advisories consisting from sowing to harvest, which provides all the information starting from the sowing to harvesting. They provide all the cultural activities related to based on the weather. For example, sowing or transplanting of kharif crops based on the onset of monsoon also provide through AgroMet advisories. Sowing of rabi crops using a residual soil moisture is also advised. Fertilizer application based on wind condition also communicated. Delay in fertilizer application based on the intensity of rain is also forecasted. Prediction of occurrence of especially the pest and diseases based on the weather also provided to the farmers to take prophylactic measures. Likewise, weeding and thinning operation is also provided based on the moisture as well as the plant population. Likewise, irrigation at critical stages of the crop is also given according to the crop stages. Quantity and timing of irrigation based on the meteorological threshold level also provided according to the soil moisture situation. Advisories for timely harvest of crop is also provided in the onset of either rainfall or monsoon. Advisories are delivered to the end users without any delay. And likewise, the interactive tuning of advisories with farmers and managers as frequently as possible through communication. It is disseminated through English as well as all the regional languages. The district level AAS based on medium range weather forecast. The IMD has started issuing a weather forecast at district level consisting of 612 districts for 5 days. From 1st June 2008 onwards. The products comprise of a forecast for 7 weather parameters, namely rainfall, maximum and minimum temperature, wind speed and wind direction, relative humidity and cloudiness. In addition, weekly cumulative rainfall forecast is also provided through district level AAS. The dissemination of agro advisories is being done through several medias, say All India Radio and Doordarshan, private TV and radio channels, newspapers, internet, ICR and other related institutes, and through agricultural universities and extension network of the state or central agricultural departments, and also Krishi Vigyan Kendras located across the nation. The future plan of AgroMet Advisory Service dissemination includes: Department of Information Technology is planning to develop ICT facilities to benefit the citizens, especially those who are living in the rural and remote areas. It is also planned to provide AIS through village knowledge centers at taluk level. The third one is IMD is exploring to tie up with different public and private partnership to provide the interactive voice response as well as the short message service, that is IVR and SMS facilities to the farmers. Likewise, automation system wherein weather forecasting will be developed automatically by utilizing the regional climate model, followed by development of agro advisory and communication to the farmers through SMS is planned. The fifth one is the climate manager or monsoon manager at village level. In each rural village of India, one man and woman candidates will be trained as a climate manager or monsoon managers to disseminate the agro advisory services at a mass scale on village level. This is about the mass communication mode of agro advisories and their effectiveness. In the next class, we would like to see the discussion on weather forecast and agro advisory services from the different websites. Thank you.